the 4 years has become a combo of all professional sports under one roof. And probably this time will be all professional sports in the bird's nest.
Why not? Because as I said,
is that something you want?
No, no. I think I want to make sure the Olympic gold medal awarded the best athletes in that sport in the world. Otherwise, why we have Olympics?
All right, Mr. Chen.
I think the spirit of Olympics, one of the very important factor is strive for the excellence. And we hope through Olympics, since this is where all the best people compete, and there you raise the standard and then you continue to excel in that sports. I think if you have that, and then regardless as amateur or as a professional, if we can achieve that target, and I think that's more important to me.
Okay. I see already David is showing some disagreement on his face, but let's take a break and we will be back after this, and we'll discuss more about all of these interesting points. We'll be back right after this break. Welcome back to Dialogue, and welcome back as well, gentlemen. With me in the studio once again, we have Chingguo Wu, who is a member of the International Olympic Committee and also president of the International Boxing Association. Sitting near to me, Tim Chen, CEO of MBA China. Meanwhile, we also have Dr. David Penn from Northeastern State University in Oklahoma, from the United States, who's been doing a lot of research about sports and Olympic development. Just now, gentlemen, I know you've been debating about whether having a combo of all professional sports under the roof of the Olympics will be the best choice for the future of the Olympics. The two gentlemen have expressed their feelings. What about you, David?
I would think, let's put into perspective for this one. Many years later in the future, if some sort of people from outer space come to this planet.
Wow, and that would be a big Hollywood story.
Yes, it would be. But if we try to dig some kind of relics on this planet, find out these kind of stadiums, they would wonder what kind of things the people on the Earth would have had celebrated. So as we know, so we are using those stadiums for sports. This is my point, you know. So I think, you know, so from my perspective, we do need Olympic Games. There's no question about for that part. But in order trying to not get into being so big, so huge, so over-commercialized, we really do need some sort of mechanism in order trying to have some sort of control.
But one might ask you, what's wrong with getting big and great and even over-commercialized? We are in a commercialized world and we have to live, athletes have to live, and people, spectators want to buy tickets. What's wrong with that?
This is also, you have to trace back to the origin of Olympic movement. For what I really mean is a contemporary Olympic movement. Mm-hmm. When Mr. Kupadan in the start Olympic Games, they trying to use the games as a event as a platform for the celebration of the peace and world youth solidarity.
But as Mr. Wu have mentioned earlier in the previous part of our show, since the 1970s, it has already been taken out of the Olympic Charter that only amateurs could participate in Lincoln Olympic Games, which means now whoever, if they can have the qualification, they can participate.
I would say the official of the IOC in regard to the amateur, as I mentioned, the eligibility of the athletes, then IOC given to the International Federation. International, you decided. That's why FIBA include the NBA to play in the 1992 games.
That's right.
That's why in 1988, the professional tennis player play in Seoul Olympic Games.
Right.
That was the beginning. Because IOC give this eligibility to the International Federation, you decide.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember 1989, I attend the FIBA Congress in Munich. In that Congress to decide whether 1992 the professional, like NBA players, whether they can play in the Olympic Games.
Mm.
All the member federations voted, I think, in favor to allow the professional player play.
What do you think might be the ultimate decision reason that they are raising their hand and voted yes?
Well, we have to be...
Is it money?
We have
is
to
it
be
the eyeball they're thinking?
No, I think reality. who is the amateur now? Every athlete receives different kind of reward.
But another question that people ask, especially with all the NBA players, the big stars coming into the Olympics, is it's eye-opening process for everybody here. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, people say this has really become the Olympics, a game of all dazzling stars who have been paid millions of dollars for their year income for playing professional. And now here again, they're being provided with another stage for honor, mm-hmm. which should originally belong at least to some of the amateurs. And now the amateurs do not even have this ground. Of course, it's debatable what is amateur and what is not.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think there's a difference. The professional league is on team-based. And then in Olympics are really on the nation-based. I think this is a different cut of the sport, which gave countries and then the people. You know, people lobby for teams. They're a fan of the teams. But really, this time is people lobby for country. So I truly believe this is a good thing for even the professional, even you probably see them a lot. Mm. But when you switch to a different combination, use NBA for example, we have about 20% of NBA players are international players. And then when they go back to the country, you know, they are able to even beat USA team. Mm-hmm. I think that shows the opportunity for everybody to get to the next layer. So
there's also an urgency from the athletes themselves, who wants to participate in their national team.
Exactly.
We heard that the soccer player Ronaldinho from Brazil, even though you know he's a Spanish a professional club, say you can't go, he said, I'm going to go back and I'm going to get a gold for Brazil anyway. So it is something from the athletes as well.
Yes, I think the most important message is doesn't matter how good you are in the professional sport, when you enter the Olympics, you have to follow the Olympic rules, mm-hmm. no exceptions. That's why in 1988, when the professional tennis player, they play in Seoul Olympic Games, they cannot stay outside the Olympic Village. They have to enter the Olympic Village, stay with the other athletes, and eating the same food. And so this is the honor, as you just mentioned. Although I have the really very top in the sport, however, if they didn't have the Olympic gold medal, it is somehow, they feel very regret. And so always like to have the opportunity in their lifetime to represent his own country, compete in the Olympic Games. Mm-hmm. And when he received that medal, gold medal in particular, so it is very significant for his career in the sport.
I'm sure a lot of people who are trying to see China's future when it comes to sports development would already become so puzzled. So where should China go, the mainland? I mean, after years of the so-called national system, where the country pays every penny for the athletes during the training, for the Olympics, now we have a system that's waiting to be reformed. So more professional, or more something like Olympic-like, or more of amateur sports? Where should we go, David?
Right now, so from these games, we can see some sort of the atmosphere over there, and one medal, one dream, two medal, two dreams, instead of the one word, one dream.
Okay.
And I think for the Chinese sports, down the line, it might have to adopt some sort of models, some sort of similar to the one in the U.S. In other words, they have to go through university colleges in order trying to develop the talent pool over there. Mm. Meanwhile, also the students who are born like in the 80s, 90s, and later on, they can develop their skills and through the sports, not only for the competition, but also in their real lifetime for their careers.
Mm. So more professional sports is what you're suggesting?
No.
Not at all?
Less. And none.
All right.
Professional sports.
Tim, David is not suggesting your system here.
No, actually, I think if you look at NBA, the view, where do you get good players? We even set the age now. We try to discourage people just finish high school and coming to MBA. What we like to do is that people at least get some level of college education. We believe strongly that the good athlete should also come up with a very good academic background because you need the smart.
That's right.
To be good at sports. I think traditionally Chinese system is more from the sports school. Like people start to do maybe 8 hours of practice a day. Right. And I don't think that's good because first, you actually very easy to get injured in the earlier stage, so you hurt the preparation.
Right.
Secondly, you really ignore a lot of academic side. And also Chinese parents, many of them doesn't really like that either. I think that you mentioned about sports reform. A lot of people, including the sports administration, they all talk about, you know, how do we improve the academic part?
Right.
And then, so I think that's where we should go to. Instead of focus on professional or amateur, really look at how we improve the current education.
Mr. Wu?
I would say the sports just like a pyramid. We have a very wide foundation. That's for sports for all. That every country have to develop. The elite sports, we go to the very high competitive sports. That's only for elite. Elite now we're talking about, whether it's through the commercial or the national support. I think for me, I think could be mixture. And partly of the government support, because you cannot immediately rely on the private sectors to support. However, through the time developed, I think you will attract a lot of commercial and private sectors want to finance, to sponsor, and to help the development of the sports. Gradually, the government role can be reduced.
They all say the Olympics in Beijing here in 2008 will be a come-out party for China to show itself, showcase itself to the rest of the world. But at the same time, as the three of you have already demonstrated, it will be also a great opportunity for China to learn what is the best from around the world and then improve itself, including its sports systems. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for coming over to our show and sharing your experiences. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good luck to the boxers at the Olympic Games.
Thank you.
Come to